It's back and loaded with more spin and power than ever before. This is the Head Graphene 360 Extreme Pro. With the addition of Graphene 360 and wider string spacing, this spin monster is the most stable racket in the Extreme family. Aggressive players will love the specs, as this 100 square inch racket has a 16 by 19 string pattern, a strong weight of 11.6 ounces, a lower 64 stiffness rating, and a serious swing weight of 331. First up, we have Eric. Now I see a big smile on your face. How did this playtest go?
Yeah, this racket was awesome. I actually used the Extreme MP in high school and college, and I was always pretty reluctant to switching to the Pro just because of the weight, but I mean, this racket, from the first ball, I loved it. I got a ton of maneuverability from this racket. It was so awesome. Great power, great spin. From the ground strokes, I felt like I could get easy depth, tons of spin, which I always look for in a racket. Tons of maneuverability up a net. That was really nice in the volleys. And I feel like I could hit as much spin as I wanted or as little spin as I wanted on the volleys and ground strokes as well. On serves, it was also awesome. With this racket, I tended to look for precision rather than a ton of power. I just feel like I got more spin and more accuracy from this racket. So that was a really nice feature. When I wanted to on the serves, I could get a lot of power from it, which was a nice feature as well, really go for my shots. But overall, I really love this racket. If I had one knock, I would definitely put a softer poly in it. It was a little bit jarring on my arm for sure. But overall, if you guys are looking for a racket with tons of spin and tons of power, this is definitely the racket for you.
Next up we have Sean. Now, you seem to gravitate towards more control-oriented rackets. This one has a lot of power, but I heard good things coming out of you as the playtest went on. How did it go?
Right, so I took this racket out with a bunch of other low-powered rackets I tend to play with, and that made it really stand out because I was having one of those days where I wasn't really feeling physically great, and I was having to put so much work in with those rackets, and I'm not normally a tweener player, but when I picked this up, I could immediately appreciate just the easy power, spin, and depth I was getting with it. If you look at my playside data, I had this ridiculously high score, for me at least, of getting the ball into the furthest depth zone. And I think that underscores just how easy the depth is to get with this racket. The string spacing's pretty wide, so you get a nice, easy launch angle. I don't think I could swing 100% all out with this racket at times, but that just let me dial back a little bit where I felt totally in control. And I liked the top spin. I was able to push my opponents back behind the baseline. The 331 swing weight made it feel pretty stable. I wouldn't say it feels like it has a 331 swing weight, more around the 320, which is kudos to this racket. That means that it swings through the air nice and easy. I like that they lowered the stiffness on it. It never felt too jarring. 64 is probably right about where I like the stiffness, maybe even a little bit lower, but for a tweener racket, I think 64 is a great number. The only knock I really have on this racket is with the same knock I have with the other 360 models, is that the response, although it's more responsive than the Graphene Touch, which was my fault with the Graphene Touch, it feels a little bit hollow in the frame, and I would like if it felt a little bit more solid while still feeling connected like it does. So overall, it was a great playtest. I think it's a good tweener frame, and I would recommend it.
Next up, we have Chris. Now, this spec is similar to your racket of choice. So how did the playtest go?
Yeah, it was super easy for me to transition out of my racket into this one. This one does have a little higher swing weight, so I got more free power out of it. Definitely added some speed to my shots, but I think I'm a little bit more accurate with my racket of choice. That being said, it was not a lot of difference, so I felt really comfortable. I felt very confident attacking the ball with this racket. Also, I like that power. I could really bail myself out of trouble. When I was on the run, I could get the ball back deep and kind of neutralize the point and then work my way back in from there. At net, I really liked the way I could line up the strings where I wanted the ball to go, got in and out really quickly and just zipped away to the target. So what we would call a point and shoot racket in that regard. On serve, I'd say better access to spin than power for me. I prefer a really heavy racket when I'm looking for a big serve, and unlike my racket, this one I can just manipulate the ball, move it around to target, so that was fun. It's probably my favorite head racket in the lineup right now, and I just really gelled with it, really enjoyed this playtest. And if you're looking for something fast, spin-friendly, powerful, it's a great option.
I was also on this playtest, and first things first, I do think that this has been my favorite Extreme Pro that I have hit with. I really gelled with this racket the more time I spent on the court with it. I found it to have a large sweet spot. It was a very forgiving string bed. And one thing that I noticed is because it does have that wider spacing in the strings, I was expecting to have crazy launch angles with my flatter strokes, but it was very consistent. My play sight numbers are almost spot on compared to my RF97, so I really love that I could hit big, hit flat still, and was rewarded. At net, I really liked attacking balls, especially with my swinging volley. I just felt like I couldn't miss with that shot. And on returns, I could get myself into a little bit of trouble if I was swinging too big, but I did appreciate that access to spin that really helped pull my balls back into the court. On serves, I just was looking for a little more weight, as Chris mentioned. And then the last thing I do want to note is the price point on this racket is amazing, and I think it's a great option for aggressive baseliners to get into a really solid tweener racket. We strung up this racket with head length 16 at 53 pounds. If you want to learn more about this racket and others, make sure you visit us at Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.